What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to another video. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, please consider subscribing to my channel. And while you're at it, smash that like button for me. I really would appreciate it. Also, hit that post notification bell so that you're notified every time I upload a new video. Be careful down in the comment section of the videos. A lot of spam, a lot of scammers. I will never ask you to contact me by WhatsApp or Telegram. I also do not invest money for my subscribers. So please be careful. Don't get yourself scammed. If you want up to 15 free stocks, Moomoo is going to give you up to 15 free stocks when you open a new Moomoo brokerage account. When you put $100 in your new Moomoo brokerage account, they're going to give you 5 free stocks. When you put $1,000 in your Moomoo brokerage account, they're going to give you 15 free stocks. There's a link down in the description box of this video. Go click on that Moomoo link. Open up your Moomoo account today. Go get that free stock. Go get that free money. There are 7 things I want to talk to you about today that I believe if you make these 7 things happen in your financial life, guys, there's no stopping you. You can have anything you want. Anything. Anything you want if you execute on these 7 things. Number 1, live on less than what you make. That's critical, guys, because the money you go out and earn is the money that you need to keep in order to invest to build wealth. So living on less than what you make is a sacrifice that most people are not willing to make. Therefore, most people live on more than what they make, and they never have enough money left over to invest to get to their financial freedom. So living on less than what you make is the number one financial principle you need to live by. The second financial principle you need to live by is live on a plan. Now, some of y'all might ask, well, Richard, what is a plan? Well, it's a financial plan. You got to know how much money you got coming in. You got to know how much money you got going out. I like to call it a financial budget, whereby I can clearly understand the money that I make, and I can clearly understand where I'm spending it. See, where you spend your money will determine your wealth. If I'm out here spending my money on things that don't put money in my pocket, only take money out of my pocket, I don't give myself a chance to multiply my money while I'm sleeping. So you got to be living on a personal budget. You got to sit down, you got to write down the income you got coming in, and you also got to write down where that money is going. We call that expenses. But there are 2 types of expenses: need expenses and want expenses. You got to cut out the wants. See, the wants are not vital to life. Your need expenses are vital to life. For example, food is a need, but going out to eat at a restaurant is a want. Totally 2 different things, right? You should be cutting out all of the wants and only focusing on the needs. And that will put you in a position where you have money left over at the end of the month so that you can invest. The third financial principle that I want you to consider living by is staying out of bad debt. Matter of fact, staying out of consumer debt is bad debt, right? Because for every dollar you are paying towards a loan payment, that's one less dollar you have to invest in your financial freedom and invest in assets that build wealth over time and create passive income. So you got to be careful out here, guys, with the car loans, with the credit cards, with these excessive homes that people are buying, more home than they need. What happens is you spend the bulk of your income. Remember, that income thing is your number one tool to build wealth. But you spend the bulk of that on debt, right? Therefore, you never have anything left over to actually put in assets that actually generate passive income. So you got to be careful with the car loans, the credit card debt, the excessive home loans. A lot of people go out and buy homes that take up 40% of their income. You'll never have anything left over to build wealth. So you got to stay out of consumer debt, and then you take that money and then you invest it in assets to build wealth. And then number four financial principle to build wealth is save and invest. Now, the save part is your emergency fund. We all need emergency fund, 3 to 6 months of our expenses tucked away in a safe place just in case we hit a financial bump in the road. That's saving. So you need to save 3 to 6 months of your expenses. Put that in a separate account, maybe a high yield savings account or something like that, away from your checking account, because you don't want them linked together, because it's too easy for you to have access to it, right? We all are human beings and we get vulnerable and we want to go out and buy stuff and treat ourselves special. No, don't connect it to your checking account. That's the savings piece, 3 to 6 months emergency fund. And then the investment piece is what we've been talking about, right? Your number one tool to build wealth is your income. Your number two tool to build wealth is what you do with that income. So if you do step one, step two, step three, the three financial principles, if you do those three things, you're going to have money left over to invest. Now, what do you do with that money to invest and multiply it? Well, I put my money in an S&P 500 ETF. When I'm talking about paper assets, you can put your money in whatever you want to put it in, as long as it has a historical track record of multiplying it. Me personally, I like to put my money in paper assets, specifically the S&P 500 ETF that tracks the S&P 500 index. I also like putting my money in what I like to call a information technology ETF, right? Which tracks the information technology industry. It exposes me to fast growing companies, right? So therefore my money grows fast with those companies. And then I like to put my money in some individual stocks. My investment plan is what I call the 50-30-20, right? 50% in broader stock market, 30% in a specific sector, and then 20% in individual stocks. That's my game plan with paper assets. Now let's move on to the last three things I want you to consider. If you want to put yourself in a position to build wealth and get where you need to get to in order to solidify your financial freedom, these are going to be three financial behaviors you need to adapt to go along with the four financial principles. Number one, discipline. Very key, guys. We got to give up something in the short term in order to get everything we want in the long term. That's discipline. When I'm giving up something right now in order to have everything I want later on, that's discipline. You are going to have to give up things that do not build wealth for you in the short term, and then redirect that money and put it in assets that do build wealth for you. You got to discipline yourself to do that. You've not been taught to do that, but you have to discipline yourself to do that if you want to be successful financially. Second thing is consistency. Remember, we talked about that investment piece in the four financial principles. Your number one tool to build wealth is your income. So you got to take that income and consistently put it in something every single month that will multiply it while you sleep. That's consistency. You got to do it every month, every year, every decade until you reach your financial freedom. That's consistency. Doing something over and over and over, waiting on a result, right? The third thing you got to do is patience. This building wealth thing, guys, is not an overnight thing. You're going to have to develop some patience. You're going to have to say, well, okay, I'm prepared to invest this money every single month, every single year, and wait and allow it to mature, allow it to develop. That's called patience. And again, we're not taught patience when it comes to our financial life in this country. It's everything right now. I don't want to wait for nothing. I want to have my riches right now. Well, the sad truth is 99% of us, it's going to take us a while to get those riches. We're going to have some patience. And I can tell you this, guys, over 30 years of experience, having patience taught me a valuable thing about money. If I can take my money, if I can put it in something with a historical track record of performance, and I can do that over a long period of time, you'll build wealth. I did it, and I believe you can. So there are your seven things, guys, that I think will equip you to get to your pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. Let me know what you think about the seven steps, four financial principles, and three financial behaviors. If you want up to 15 free stocks, Moo Moo is going to give you up to 15 free stocks. You got to get down in that description box, though, and click on that link. And Moo Moo is going to give you up to 15 free stocks. When you put $100 in there, you're going to get 5 free stocks. When you put $1,000 in your new brokerage account, you're going to get 15 free stocks. Guys, don't miss this opportunity. Go get that free stock. Go get that free money. While you're there, check out the website, www.richardfain.net. Fastest growing financial community on Patreon is the Wealth Builders. That's part of our group of people who are dedicated to getting to wealth and helping each other get there. We are the fastest growing financial community on Patreon. Consider joining us through the website. That would be the second link down in the description box. Click on that website link and check out those digital products that we have available for you to help you collapse time frames and get to your pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. And then hit that membership button or that join button and join the Wealth Builders. Guys, we're waiting on you. We're looking forward to having you guys over there. We are the fastest growing financial community on Patreon, and we're there to help each other build wealth in community style. Like I said, fastest growing community on Patreon. Come check us out. If you're stopping by the channel for the first time, please consider subscribing, share the video, smash the like button. Thoughts become things. If you can see it in your mind, you can hold it in your hands. You guys keep chasing your greatness. Never stop believing in yourself. Stay healthy, get wealthy, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.